It took about a week for the water to rise to this level, and now we're seeing barricades all along the Arkansas River warning people not to go in. This, however, is typically a park where people tell me they come here on Sundays after church to eat their lunch. Now you can't even see where a play set or the swing set is supposed to be. And if you pan over to the right a little bit, you'll see a lot more light poles. Those are supposed to be shining down on basketball courts, and we can't even see the top of those hoops right now. This is an unprecedented historic event for the local officials to try and figure out how to mitigate the disaster. We spoke to Senator Tom Cotton earlier, who told us this is a devastating thing to see in his hometown.
You can see the volume of water that's flowing through this dam, the immense flooding of this historic flood. Just south of Dardanelle, we've had a levee breach, unfortunately, which may end up flooding some of southern Dardanelle coming around through the bayou in the back. It just gives you a sense of the scale of this natural disaster that we've had here in the Arkansas River Valley.
We took a helicopter tour earlier to take a look at that levee breach. That opening is now larger than it was just a day ago. And right now, that river is covering all of this farmland crops like soybeans, corn, rice. That is all ruined for what I'm told could be 3 to 5 years. So a lot of farmers right now are looking at their financial future with a lot of concern. People are helping each other out here, but a lot of folks have also voluntarily evacuated their homes. There are hundreds of homes threatened, not just by flooding, but some of them are just inaccessible because of road closures. Now, this water could take weeks to recede, and only then will people be able to tell the extent of the damage here and what kind of federal assistance is needed. Natasha Chen, CNN, Dardanelle, Arkansas.